Amen. We thank the Lord this day. For the Bible said in Psalm 118, verse 24, so this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for granting us this special day which He has made. Beloved, this is God's Warfare and Intercession Ministry, and we have come your way again. When we say Jiwim, we respond the word and prayer. Jiwim, the word and prayer. And this day, God has blessed us with another theme. It's one which you have heard before, but this time, a special grace has been granted unto us for this particular theme. And He says, pray again. The theme for this one night is pray again. The Bible makes us understand that, therefore, if there is a Christian who does not pray, then he is not of the household of faith. Nothing distinguishes the child of God so clearly as prayer. True Christians are prayerful. The worldly minded are prayerless. And the Bible said in Luke chapter 18, verse 1, the Lord our Savior Jesus, as I read verse 1, says, then he spoke a parable to them that men always ought to pray and not lose heart. The Bible makes us understand that Jesus was speaking to them. He needed to present it in a way for them to understand. So he gave them a parable. All he was trying to tell us is that we ought to pray and not lose heart. Other version says, and not faint. Jesus gave us this parable, meaning that we must always pray. And the theme says, pray again. We want to see some of the characteristics that embark on this journey. It is not a sin to pray again. You have not lacked faith. You did not backslide also. Rather, it is a kind of grace God has granted to us for a higher dimension of answering prayers. So he says, pray again. Let's look at one of our fathers in the Lord in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 43 to 44. And he said to his servant, go up now, look toward the sea. So he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And seven times he said, go again. Child of God, shout, go again. So meaning that seven times he said, go again. Verse 44, then it came to pass the seventh time that he said, there is a cloud as small as a man's hand rising out of the sea. So he said, go up, say to Ahab, prepare your chariot and go down before the rain stops you. So the man of God here prayed seven times. He prayed seven times. That is why he sent his servants, go again. This prophet Elijah was about to call down rain after a long period of drought. And the Bible said, he bowed down on the ground and put his face between his knees. And he prayed and asked the servant, go again, go again, go again, seven times. And this time he said, I saw. There is a special grace in praying again. And God intentionally prepared her for the mighty move of the soul toward him. Praying again is a kind of prayer which is different from all that we know. The basic theology we know defines prayer as the communication between God and man. But as you advance in what we call advanced practical theology, you will understand that prayer is not just communication. Prayer now becomes a move and a force. It becomes a burning desire and of the soul and of the spirit that until I get an answer and until I get a solution, I am not stopping. I did not just come to commune. I didn't just come to say, hello, God, or good morning, Jesus. I came for a kind of persistence. I came for a kind of traveling. I came for a kind of pushing and holding till I get my answer. And he said, it's very spiritual and scriptural to pray again. And Jesus said, what he's telling us is something he's done before in Matthew 26, 44. So he left them, went away again and prayed the third time, saying the same words. Even Jesus Christ, our Lord Savior, prayed the third time. Child of God, receive strength as you embark on this journey. Whatever that you have prayed before that looks delaying, as you pray again, he says he releases an answer to you. Oh, Shatapaha, Derantulazi Blahaba. The Apostle Paul said, In 1 Thessalonians 5:17, as we have fasted and prayed these days, that God should baptize us with the spirit of prayer. In 1 Thessalonians 5:17, it says, pray without ceasing. God has granted you an ability to pray without stopping, to pray without quitting. And as we are praying again this one night, something is about to happen. A mighty move of God is about to happen. And the apostle said, what I'm telling you to pray without ceasing is something I have done over and over. In 2 Corinthians 12:8, concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me. Child of God, you have quitted so fast. You stopped so fast. The apostle Paul said, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times. He prayed 3 times. So Jesus came to the disciples and said, you could not even tarry with me 1 hour. So if you could pray 3 times, then it's still like he prayed almost 3 hours. From all that we read and all that we gathered, we can say in conclusion that Elijah prayed 7 times. Jesus prayed 3 times. The apostle Paul also prayed 3 times. Child of God, it is time for you to move to the next dimension. As you lift up your voice this day, that special grace of praying without quitting is resting upon you. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, he who does not pray cannot claim to be a Christian. He can possibly not be called a Christian. There is no possible way that he can claim any right to the term or its implied significance. If you are a Christian, then you will be prayerful. He who is known cannot claim so. Child of God, there is a day that the Lord said, pray again. Enough of the wavering and the complaining. Time has come to pray again. And we are praying with 2 prayer topics. We are praying and saying, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, as I have found grace in your sight, through Christ Jesus, please show me your glory. John 1:17, may understand that the Lord came through Moses, but truth and grace came through Christ Jesus. As God is about to show you his glory, your situation will be turned around. You have prayed and prayed, but this time let's pray again. A special unction of the Holy Ghost rests upon us all to pray again. And the second prayer goes this way. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, do a new thing in my life. In Isaiah 43, 18 to 19. Child of God, you have prayed for new things. This time you say, pray again. You want solution to certain things you don't understand. We have come this way with the word of the Lord to encourage you and to make you understand that the Holy Spirit rests upon you to pray again. Oh, Shekan Daka, hey, Fataba Suprahantala Bila Sula, Aqua Sheke Leketu Pala, hey, Satan Prabadabadu Seprintelebe. We are taking these 2 prayer topics each for 3 hours. By the time we return from this 6-hour prayer, your life will never be the same again. Be encouraged. Child of God, receive grace. Receive the anointing to travail. I tell you, it is God himself who said, pray again. Child of God, your life will never be the same. In these difficult times, in these difficult situations, when all men are looking for different forms of alternatives, God says, no, do not turn to the left, do not turn to the right. Neither look back. The same prayer you have been praying, pray again. I'm about to do something new. Child of God, there is a mystery in the realms of the spirit. Today that pray again, it shows how stable they are. It shows how serious they are. It shows how practical they meant their words. God is calling for such ones. As you pray again, you are coming into the family of Elijah, into the family of Jesus, and into the family of Apostle Paul. Ah, lekase palakata, ipalo sala, jetepete ke atupalaka, veshum prepetepetu sakalaka, jetetekete kreketeketu, jetem prepadasu palahita lakitaka, hey, jetetekete prepete suprahada labadu, jetem prepetepe, hold on, press on, don't give up. The next time we meet again, you are coming with your testimony in Jesus' name. Amen.